Entry-level phones are the best ways to get into the smartphone world. And for those of you who are on a tight budget, you might be limited to phones that are below 1,000 ringgits. However, one must understand that phones in this price point do not offer the best smartphone experience compared to phones with a higher price point. But nevertheless, the Redmi 5 has proven to be a decent entry-level phone for the first 2 weeks. With the Redmi 5 being an entry-level phone, it comes with a full plastic body. However, it does feel solid and seems to provide some quality to its craftsmanship, which is really nice to see in a phone with a low price point. For those of you that like to get protection for your phones, there is a TPU case that comes with the phone, so you don't have to go out and hunt for one. Similar to a lot of the other Xiaomi phones, there is an IR blaster which works perfectly with my aircon and TV back at home. As most of you know, I really like this feature and I hope that all phone manufacturers adopt this. The phone comes with a 5.7 inch 18:9 aspect ratio HD LCD screen, which for its price range does produce some very decent colours. It was quite enjoyable to watch some videos on Netflix and YouTube. Good effort by Xiaomi to take the extra step with the screen quality. Even if the screen covers the majority of the front of the phone, to some, it might not be great as there's still very obvious bezels on the top, bottom and sides. It would be nice to see a USB Type-C port on the device, but I understand the decision to go with a micro USB as it would cut down the cost of the phone. Being an entry-level phone, the Redmi 5 comes with some modest specs like the Snapdragon 450 processor, 32GB of expandable storage and 3GB of RAM. For the first 2 weeks of using this phone, I had not experienced any lags or slowdowns when using it. Regular apps like WhatsApp, Facebook and YouTube had no issues loading up and they performed better than expected from a phone at this level. However, as I mentioned at the start of this video, the performance seems to only last 2 weeks and after that I experienced a lot of crashes and lags on the mentioned app. It was quite disappointing that the degradation in performance was so fast, and only after performing a full reset did I manage to get the phone back to a decent performance. That aside, I was honestly surprised that graphic-intensive games like Shadowgun Legends is very playable, aside from the slow loading times. I'm also quite impressed with the speakers on this phone. Vocals are very clean and it can get really loud. It might be lacking some bass, but it's safe to say that these speakers are still better than a lot of cheap Bluetooth speakers out there. The phone comes with a single 12 megapixel rear camera. It does not perform well if you're comparing it to other camera focused phones or more expensive phones, but for an entry level setup, it can work rather well in lighted up areas. The color reproduction is not great by any means, but pictures do come out clear, and if you don't really care much about photo taking, then this camera still does a decent job. The 5 megapixel front camera on the other hand might not satisfy your selfie needs, as colors are very flat and it does not perform well when capturing details. I'm not going to give this phone a hard time on its photo-taking capabilities as I can see that there is some effort put into the cameras. The camera software is also pretty basic. You will be getting some room to play around with the manual settings but don't expect to be taking better pictures just through the manual mode as it only offers two options of changing the white balance and adjusting the ISO. Performance and photography might not be the best on the Redmi 5, but the battery life is truly excellent. The 3300mAh battery has managed to last 2 days based on my use of browsing social media, watching YouTube and sending text messages. If I slot in a game or two in between, it could still last up to 1.5 days. Even if you do run out of battery, the phone does support Quick Charge 2.0 and will get you a full charge in just about 1.5 hours. So if you're interested in getting yourself the Redmi 5, this phone retails for 679 ringgits, but I honestly feel that that is a bit on the expensive side for an entry-level phone because if you're willing to put in another 100 or 200 ringgits, you can probably get yourself the Mi A1, which comes with a mid-range processor and a much better camera. So guys, I hope you like this video. If you do, do give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not because we do take out videos like this every week. And of course, I'll see you in the next video.